Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the Blazor calendar component of Syncfusion. In general, the calendar component is used to view and select dates. In this video, I'll explain you how easy it is to add a Blazor calendar of Syncfusion to a server-side Blazor application. Then, I will show you how to configure a few of its important features like setting specific date range values to the calendar, multi-date selection, and navigation between different calendar views such as month, year, and decade. Let me start with the application creation process. I can create a Blazor application either using Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'll show you how to create a server-side Blazor application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or a later version. Now open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Select Blazor app from the template and click the Next button. Now I will name my project and click the Create button. Here, I will choose the Blazor server app. The project has been created and is ready to use. Now, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding a Blazor calendar to it. To add and start using a Blazor calendar, first I need to install the necessary Syncfusion Blazor packages. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager. I search for syncfusion.blazor and install it into my application. Once installed, you can see that the Blazor packages have been added to this application package folder. Now, to add a Blazor calendar, first I'll navigate to the imports.razor page and import the namespace syncfusion.blazor.calendars. Then, I need to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. For that, I will navigate to the startup.cs file and add the syncfusion.blazor namespace. And then make a call to the syncfusion blazor service method inside the configure services method. Now, within the configure method, I will also register the syncfusion license by passing the trial license key in the register license method. Next, I will navigate to the host.cs.html page and add a CSS reference from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now, the configuration steps are done, so let me continue to add the Blazor calendar component. For that, I will open the index component and then include the SF calendar tag and then add tValue property to specify the type of the component and set its value type to date time. Now I will run my application by pressing FI key. See the output. Calendar with today's date is highlighted. You can also navigate back and forth between the calendar dates, months, and years. Next, I will show you how to select a specific date value on the calendar. Dates can be specified using the value property. I will directly bind a value by writing a C# code using @code directive. I will define a variable date value of type date time and assign some date value to it. Say for example 20 March 2020. Then assign this variable to the value property of the calendar. When you check the output, you will find the provided date value selected on the calendar. Now, let me show you how to restrict the date value selection within a specified range by defining the min and max properties. Now, I will add the start date variable of date time type and set some date value, for example, March 10, 2020. Similarly, I will include end date variable and set some date value, for example, March 22, 2020. Assign these variables to the min and max properties of calendar. See the output. Now I can only select the date between March 10, 2020 and March 22, 2020. You can also see the other dates that are out of range or restricted to select. You can select multiple dates in a calendar by including the isMultiSelection property and setting its value to true. Here, I will select multiple date values in the calendar. Finally, I will show you how to change and navigate between different views of the calendar. There are three types of views: month, year, and decade. So far, we have seen the default month view. Now, I will change the view to decade using the start property. I will include the start property and set its value to decade. Now, the calendar displays the years in a decade. When I click a specific year in the calendar, it will show the list of months in a year, and on further clicking of a month, it will show the days of the selected month. Now, we saw the drill down action of a calendar view navigation from decade to month view using the start property. Next, I will show you how to control the drill up action of a calendar view navigation using depth property. Using start and depth properties together, I can limit the drill down and drill up actions of the calendar while navigating through the views. So let me include the depth property and set its value to year now. Note that the depth value should be always lesser than the start value. As you can see, when I select any year from the calendar, it will list out the months in a year, and on clicking any month, it will not show the days of that month. Now, I will quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a Blazor Server app using Visual Studio 2019 and added a calendar component to it. And then I explained how to configure the component with its features like setting a specific date value and date range to it. Finally, I showed you how to select multiple dates in the calendar component and then the different views such as month, year, and decade. You can download this working example from a GitHub link which I have shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community guidelines. So check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.